To give you an example of a data model, let me use the relational model and let me illustrate to you what data structures and constraints and operations look like in that model. In the relational model, data is represented in tables. Tables have names, in this case, regular user. Each column has a name, email, birth date, hometown, salary. Each one of the columns has a data type. In this case, emails are represented over varchar 50, variable length character strings, maximum length 50. Birth date is represented over date time data type. Hometown again over varchar 50. Salary is represented over the data type integer. A table is set to have columns. In this case, there are four columns. The number of columns is also called the degree of the table. A relation also has a number of rows. In this case, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 rows in the table. The table name, column names, and data types together constitute the schema of this table. The schema represents aspects of the data that are stable over time. In other words, the schema is not expected to change. The state of the database, represented by the rows in the table, reflect aspects that are dynamic and change over time. So the idea is that whereas the schema in general represents the structure of data, the rows will represent what is the current state of reality that's modeled by this table.